All right, Dan Brady here. Gonna ask him some questions. How long have you been coming to Q?
Since March of 2017.
So a little over a year.
A little over a year.
Yep. Okay. How or what kind of stuff did you do prior to coming to HEW?
Prior to HEW, I did CrossFit for about a year. Orange Theory for about 2 years. Body Tech, which is like HIIT training, for about a year. Then I came here.
Okay, a lot of people don't really know how to describe HEW, and you're pretty well-rounded in terms of like experience in different fitness little genres. What would you like kind of say is the difference, or what's different between them all?
I would say that this is probably the perfect blend of all of those modalities. There's, you know, weights that are similar to CrossFit, but not as kind of strong on the one rep max, and not as kind of weight centered. There's also a decent amount of cardio, but it's not, you know, a half hour of cardio and nothing but cardio. So I would say that it's a good mixture of all of them. There's weights, there's gymnastics, there's cardio, and it's always varied. So it's not the same thing every day.
Okay. How was were you? You probably weren't intimidated or anything like that coming in, were you?
I was intimidated by some of the more gymnastics moves, so some of the kipping moves, rope climbs were intimidating, some of the handstand push-ups, that was a little intimidating.
So our biggest obstacle is intimidation and fear and just lack of confidence.
Yeah.
How, like, you were intimidated, but how did the staff and how did Hugh or HEW, like, kind of take care of it and kind of comfort that fear, I guess?
I think all the coaches work with you where you are. There's no expectation that you need to perform just like, you know, the other people that are in your workout. Everything is scaled to you individually if you need it, and there's always attention to you if, you know, if you need some extra attention. So even though I was intimidated by something, I found that everybody would break it down into steps that were much easier for me to handle until I could progress and make it to doing a rope climb without the knots or.
So there was a lot of stuff, even with your experience, there was stuff that you didn't know how to do coming in here, but the coaches, like, they demonstrate everything for you and they show you everything?
Yeah, absolutely. I always felt like everything was always well demonstrated, scaled if I needed to, but always, you know, I always felt very motivated when I'm here.
Okay, tell me about the clients, like the other members, the other, we call them humans.
All right, so the other humans are all, I think they're kind of excellent people to work out with. They're all very motivating. They're very encouraging. They're from all different fitness levels, which is kind of nice. One of the things that I thought was a little intimidating about something like CrossFit is that you tend to get all these, you know, 25-year-old guys who are all, you know, muscle heads, and all they want to do is, you know, lift, and that's it. Here, there's just, you know, it's a menagerie of all different, you know, body types, ages. And so I found that, you know, everybody's very encouraging, and, you know, you can be wherever you are, you know, in your fitness journey and still end up, you know, coming out, improving your own fitness.
Now, what would you tell somebody that has thought about coming, they've seen our brand, they've intimidated, that fear factor's there? If you were on one-on-one and you met them and they were like, oh my God, I can never do that stuff, what would you tell them?
You absolutely can do that stuff, because everything is, you know, you can break everything down into baby steps. You know, if you can't do a double under, they're gonna teach you how to jump rope, you know, just to start with, and then work yourself up to a double under. If you can't do a pull-up, they can, you know, scale it so that you can learn how to do a basic pull-up, and then a strict pull-up, and then a kipping pull-up. So it doesn't matter where you are in your fitness journey or where you are in your skill set, there's something here for everybody, you know, and everything is scalable. So I don't think there's any reason to be, you know, intimidated and not do it. You should be intimidated but feel challenged by it. You know, you should feel like, all right, that's a little challenging, but I can do it and they're gonna help me.
Cool. All right, Dan, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
We love having you here, man.